En af hovedretningerne inden for tibetansk buddhisme hedder Karma Kagyi. Retningens åndelige leder kalder man handlingens mand på tibetansk Karmapa. Ifølge de troende er han blevet reinkarneret 16 gange, siden han levede første gang i det 12. århundrede. Men i 1980'erne opstod der uenighed om, hvem der er nummer 17 i rækken, for to mænd siger begge, at de er reinkarnationen. En af de to er den 21-årige Taye Dodge, som netop har besøgt Danmark. Da han var bare 1½ år gammel, meddelte han verden, at det er ham, der er den 17. Karmapa, yogiernes konge, handlingens mand.
When you were 1½ years old, you told your parents that you were the incarnation of the Karmapa.
Yes.
Can you recall what that was like, that realization?
I think at that time I did say that, yes, to my parents, especially my mom was there. And also the sister of my predecessor.
Right.
Was also there. But it was at her house, at her apartment.
Mm-hmm.
And but of course now, it's been now, let's see, now after 20 years or 19 years, it's been a long time, so.
Sure.
Yes. So it's quite vague.
Have you ever doubted it? Have you ever said, I'm not sure I am the incarnation, I don't want to be the incarnation? Is that an option, a possibility? Have you ever been tempted to do that?
Actually, it's sort of not much of a possibility, I think.
Right.
Yes. But, sort of from the first incarnation of Karmapa, from the moment Manasim sort of made a promise and made a wish that we'll continue the activity,
right,
to reach life.
Yeah.
So in that way, there's not much going back.
No.
Yes.
No.
But no, actually, I don't know. I haven't really felt that much of a doubt.
No.
No, this felt quite natural.
Right.
Yeah.
Now, you're traveling all over the West and visiting with people who are Buddhists, who are interested, yes, in becoming Buddhists, who have just heard about it. What is the first question that everybody asks about Buddhism?
I guess mostly they ask about the quality of Buddhism.
Right.
Yes, so, which is, of course, not causing any harm,
yeah,
by practicing or using Dharma. That's, I think,
using Dharma.
Yes.
Right. To explain to us the concept of Dharma.
Yes. Well, Dharma, of course, it is simply a method.
Right.
Sort of bring out, or to a way to express one's very own nature of everything.
Yeah.
Yes. So it is, of course, in this, I would say, time of the Buddha Shakyamuni.
Mm-hmm. Who is the one, who is the Buddha for our...
Who brought Dharma,
yeah,
to this world, was simply a teaching and a method to realize the nature of everything.
Yeah.
Yes.
Would you call Buddhism a religion, a philosophy? What is it?
Actually, first of all, like when Buddhism first came out from Tibet and then into the West like that, I think during that time it was very new. So for that reason, it was difficult to translate what is Buddhism, right? And in that way, I think there were times that religion was used,
mm-hmm,
because in some ways it seems like that.
Yeah,
but actually, it is not a religion.
Why not? Why isn't it a religion?
Because you see, it's this religion. Of course, no, my English isn't perfect, but
sure.
Religion, from what I understood, was that it is about it is a way to link between oneself and to the God, right?
Yes, sure.
Yes. And in Buddhism, there's no such thing.
No.
It's just our minds.
And so this is, I guess, is one of the things that's difficult for Westerners to understand, because, yeah, when you come with a Christian background or a knowledge of the Christianity as a religion,
mm-hmm,
you sort of seem to search for God.
Yes.
And so this is why people come to believe that Buddha,
yes,
was a God, but he wasn't, was he?
Well, he wasn't.
No.
No, no. He was simply a teacher, someone who showed us the way to awake one's sort of mind,
uh-huh,
yes, because everything that we see in this time the things that we feel, what we hear, everything is just sort of more or less an illusion.
Yeah.
Yes, so it's just a way to sort of, to tap and then to wake up.
Sure.
In each era, there is a Buddha.
Yeah.
Sort of like the main figure who will show us the way. Of course, in truth, actually, almost every one of us are searching the same, that's where we all go.
Right.
Yes.
We can all become Buddhas?
Yes, we all.
Mm-hmm.
The reason for that is that we have the what we call is Buddha nature. Yes. Not just human beings, but every sentient being.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Dogs, cats, flies, or butterflies.
Are there people who can never benefit from Buddhism and who can't come out of it with anything, who simply aren't suited for it? Or is everybody suited for it and just...
It depends, you see. Depends on one's karma.
Mm-hmm.
For some, might be very... for them, they would like to practice Dharma or how to use Dharma. But for some, maybe it isn't that easy.